This is Dr. Kazi. Imagine you are digging a grave and you find two skeletons. You do not know which skeleton is of the male and which one is the female. As a medical student, how will you differentiate between these two skeletons? So in this video, we are going to learn about the biological differences between the male as well as the female on the basis of the pelvic cavity. Before discussing into the detail, let us revise what we already know about the pelvic cavity. Now, look at this diagram. We know that the entry point into the pelvic cavity is known as the pelvic inlet or the pelvic brim. This red dotted line represents the pelvic inlet or the pelvic brim. Now, how this pelvic inlet or the brim is formed, I have discussed that in the previous video, but let me revise it. The iliopectineal line will form the pelvic brim. This iliopectineal line is on the medial side of one hip bone. When two hip bones join together and we trace the iliopectineal line from one bone to the other, we obtain the pelvic brim or the pelvic inlet. Now, below this pelvic inlet, we have the true pelvis. And above this pelvic inlet, we have the false pelvis. Now we are ready to discuss about the biological difference between the male pelvis and the female pelvis. Have a look at the pelvis of the female and the pelvis of the male. Now, the biological differences are very obvious in this bony structure. The female pelvis has the obvious adaptation for the childbirth, but in case of the male pelvis, we have thicker bones and the prominent bony marking. Now, first of all, look at the false pelvis of the female. The false pelvis of the female is shallow as comparison to the false pelvis of the male, which is deeper. Look at the pelvic inlet of the male pelvis. It is heart-shaped. If you trace this red dotted line, which represents the pelvic inlet or the pelvic brim, this is heart-shaped in case of males. But if you look at the pelvic inlet or the pelvic brim in case of female, it is oval, like this. Okay? Now let us see pelvic outlet. This pelvic inlet will lead into the cavity known as the pelvic cavity. And after the pelvic cavity, we have the pelvic outlet. In case of males, the pelvic outlet is small. But in case of female, the pelvic outlet is large. Because the female have to bear the child, and during labor, this pelvis should be larger so that the child can be easily born. So this pelvic outlet is large in case of female, but in case of male, the pelvic outlet is smaller. Now, look at the pelvic cavity of the males as well as the female. Note the distance between the pelvic inlet and the pelvic outlet. It is greater in case of males, but the distance between the pelvic inlet and the pelvic outlet is smaller in case of female. It means the pelvic cavity in case of female is small as comparison to the pelvic cavity in case of male. Look at the sacrum bone of the female. It is flatter and more wider compared with the sacrum bone of the male. It is not as flatter as the female bone. Now, in the end, we have to look at the pubic arc or the subpubic angle. Now, what is the subpubic arc or the angle? Look in front of the ischiopubic rami of the male pelvis as well as the female pelvis. In front of the ischiopubic rami, we have the subpubic angle or the pubic arc like this. It is less than 90 degree in case of the males, but you look at the pubic arc of the female, it is greater than the 90 degree angle. By this method, you can easily differentiate between the male pelvis and the female pelvis. Hence, you can identify which skeleton is of the male and which one is of the female. Thank you so much for watching. Please do like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.